So yeah, it started with a journey across the Middle East and meeting people my age, like young artists, young creatives, and you know, seeing that they didn't really have so much of a platform. No one was listening to them, especially not in the West, and realizing that, you know, with my skills and my background in the London art scene, that I could work with them and I could help them gain a voice and, you know, start connecting people, especially young people, between the Middle East and the UK. Well, I think from this part of the world, we forget like the shared heritage and the shared values that we have with the Middle East. You know, we see it as maybe somewhere quite different, but actually to me it was somewhere quite similar. You know, religion-wise, it's incredibly similar. So I related to it a little bit on that level. Secondly, I felt like, you know, as an artist, selfishly, you want to be where it's at, you know, where things are happening, where everyone's talking about all the energy is. And you felt like there was something both positive and negative happening in the Middle East at that time. And that if you're an artist or a writer or a creative, you should be, you know, you should be where it's at. You should be at the center. General perception of Middle Eastern art is that it's emerging, that it's something I think a bit exciting. The art market and the museums are starting to pick up on it. It's very early days, and I think sometimes what's happening on the ground in the Middle East is very different from what you might read about in the newspapers or the government is saying. I feel like there's a generation that are very, we have the same ideals, a generation in London and in the UK and a generation in the Middle East. You know, we feel like there's a really strong group now, especially in the Gulf, in fact. It's a good movement, and it's a movement worth fighting for and worth investing in.